So I finally caved and I am now part of the Casio Oak army. I'm not a huge G-Shock collector, but I couldn't resist picking up this piece on the sale that we have on this online platform in Singapore. This watch retails for an MSRP of, I think it was $179 during the sale on the 12th of December, 12/12. I picked this up for $98 with all the online coupons and whatnot. So I think this is an absolute steal. And well, I resisted this for a long time and I finally gave in to temptation when I saw these new neon colors. This is really something which I just can't resist. I always say that I love orange on everything, but at the end of the day, I just can't seem to find the right shade or the right way orange is executed. And I think in this particular case, it really is done in a very, very nice, very, very cool, classic manner and not overbearing in any regard. So as I mentioned, I'm not a huge G-Shock collector, so I'm not too familiar with the functions. I'm not too familiar with the way everything works in the module, but I just wanted to put this video out there to show you guys what this awesome watch looks like. I think for the money, you really can't go wrong. This watch came in this packaging, and yeah, it's a pretty typical G-Shock packaging. Of course, this box is a little bit more different than what I'm used to. I don't have many G-Shocks, but yeah, they pretty much all come in this hexagonal box. And this particular reference is the GA2100-1A4DR. So I believe they have a orange one, they have a green one, as well as another color. I think it's a blue one. So for the neon series, these are the few colors for you to choose from. I went with the orange. I really love the way it contrasts with everything else, with the black resin case, with the black dial. And of course, well, being part of the Casio Oak army now, I'm definitely gonna mod this watch sooner or later. But as it is on this resin case and the resin band, it has been very, very comfortable for my 7-inch or so wrist. So let me just put this on real quick to show you guys what it looks like. Some G-Shocks feel very bulky, and I'm glad to report that this one does not. So I think you guys can agree. Let me get all these distractions out of the way. Yeah, so this is the G-Shock GA2100 in this particular variant on my 6.9 to 7-inch wrist. So I think it wears very well. The size suits me. It is pretty compact, I must say, and it is quite thin. I'm not sure, but I think I read somewhere that this is one of the thinnest G-Shocks around. And yeah, so that would really be a great feature and a great size for somebody who has always wanted to get G-Shocks, but then always felt that they were too big and too bulky. So yeah, just get a look at that. So look at the contrast of the hands, look at the contrast of the markers and the indices. And also this LED display. What I understand is that the color of this LED display is different for the different color variants of this neon series. So for orange, you have orange writing over here. Whereas if you have a green, it'll be green writing. And if you have a blue, it'll be blue writing. Yeah. So here's the backlight for you. Yeah, so as you can see, very, very nice, very legible. And I found something pretty cool as well. The hands of the watch will go out of the way when you press the adjust button. I'm not sure if it do it now. I think it will. So let me just try to do that. Oh yeah. So it will just get out of the way for you to see the display to make your adjustments. And when you're done, when you click this, it'll go slowly back to position. I think that's really cool. I don't know whether I'm just living under a rock, but yeah, I'm so unfamiliar with G-Shocks and the modules and the way they work that this amazes me. It's just like a toy and yeah, it's just a big kid here. So very, very nice. G-Shock GA2100 in the neon orange colorway. I think the hands are loomed as well. So let me just do this here. And this is probably the first G-Shock I've ever handled with loomed hands, and that is pretty amazing. Yes, look at that, wow. So, you have a G-Shock with an analog display, and you don't even need to use the light, the backlight to tell the time. Very awesome. So guys, I think if you guys are interested in any of the Casio Oak series, I think this Neon series is the one to really look out for. I think the module inside is pretty simple. It doesn't have solar. It's quite basic functions that it comes with. But well, if you're not in it for the functions, but you're more in it for the style and the ruggedness that G-Shock always brings along with all of their watches, definitely consider picking this one up. So thank you guys so much. And as usual, please take care and stay safe. And I'll see you on the next video.